Hey everyone, welcome back to Banjo-Kazooie. In this video, we're going to head to the next world of the game, Treasure Trove Cove. We opened this up last time, so let's head in. Okay, this is the game's beach-themed world, and I love the music here. Oh, we have something from Bottles. Okay, he's just talking about how there's two new moves to find here. We'll get to those in a moment. As you can see, there is a Jinjo under the starting point. This one's kind of tricky to get because this water here is shark infested. There's like one shark that comes out and pretty much tries to get you every time you go in the water, so try to hurry up and get him. Oh, he's gonna get me. Oh, wait. Oh, I got away from him. Okay. Usually he does get me there. Okay, these crabs. I don't remember a lot of the enemy names. They don't tell you in-game, so you'd have to look those up. Yeah, they don't really tell you a lot of the enemy names in the game, so I'm just going to call them by what kind of animal they are, what I think they are. Okay, feathers. We're actually going to learn how to fly in this level, too. Wait, do I want to go here now? Yeah, let's go here. You can see there is a big, ugly hermit crab-looking thing over there. It's actually a boss. He's really not that difficult. Wait. Yeah, where did he come from? Oh yeah, if you... I can't remember the name of that move. The ground pound, whatever. If you ground pound them instead of flipping them over and then attacking them, you get two little honeycomb things. Oh, this is Nipper. Okay. As I said in, I think, the last video or the one before that, I'm just going to skip a lot of the dialogue. It kind of goes by a bit slowly. Okay, he does have a certain attack pattern, which does get a little bit faster, but you just have to poke him in the eyes. Okay, I think one more time should do it. There we go. Alright. That's actually the last you see of him. Now let's grab this real quick. Wait, I don't think you can go up there. I mean, even if you do, I don't think there's anything up there, right? No. Okay, just making sure. Alright, let's head in. Music is a little bit more calm. Okay, he may be gone, but in his place are two of the little crab guys. Oops. Okay. And here is the first Jiggy. Okay, that's pretty much all you need to do in here. Actually, I could just run out. I, like, walked in here. Alright, but yeah, that's all you can do in here, so let's head back out. And that is pretty much the last you see of Nipper. I mean, most of the bosses... Yeah, I think you only see them, like, once. Okay, that right there, that's gonna be something we're gonna learn about very soon. The thing about this world is there's actually... It's pretty big compared to Mumbo's Mountain. So there's a lot of things to do. I'm just gonna, you know, get whatever I can in whatever order that, you know, comes to mind first. There's probably a less time-consuming way to go about this world, but, it's alright. I'm not too worried about taking too long. Kind of like just exploring everywhere, too. Oh, we can help him. We'll come back to him, though. That bucket. Forgot his name. I think he's Leaky or something like that. Actually, let's help him out. Not sure how loud it is, but he's crying right now. He's pretty loud. Oh, wait, maybe... Yeah, I don't think you can hear him now. When you get closer, you can definitely hear him. It's like a really distinct cry. Okay, Bottles is there. We'll talk to him after we're done with the salty hippo. Yeah, Captain Blubber, he talks in like burps. It's It's a hippo that can't swim. Okay, well, we have to find his gold, but he'll reward us. Let's actually go in here first. I guess he got shipwrecked here? I'm not sure what the official story is, but... I mean, this is his ship. He probably did get shipwrecked. Okay, here's one of his gold bars. Or pile of gold bars. Okay. So yeah, as you can see, there's actually a section on the other side. We'll have to go in there a different way. Oh, let's hand him this. Wait, where do I give it to him? Oh, you know what? I don't think I can throw it yet. I think you have to have both. Because I know Banjo throws it to the side for him. But, yeah, I think I have to get the second one. Oh, man. I've never been the biggest fan of swimming in this game. I think I mentioned this already, but there's some worlds later on that have some really scary swimming parts because... Well, it's pretty easy to drown if you mess up. And the thing is, I really hate drowning in these platformers. It's not a good feeling when you drown. Okay. We have both of his gold piles. Hey. Oh, you have to go up to him, okay. Okay, so that was a reward. Another jiggy. Okay, and I did forget this right here. Those, I'm not gonna collect all of them, because there's probably some that I don't know where they are. But, you know, the ones that I do remember, I'll get them. The Jinjo here, too. Alright, let's talk to Bottles. And he's gonna teach us how to fly. Okay, as you can see, the flying discs, they're all activated now. Okay, so all you have to do is just jump on one of the flying discs, and that's it. On the Xbox controller, you can hit A to go up a little bit, but it uses up a feather. Oh, shoot. Oh, I jumped too early. Oh, let's get out of here. I'm Snacker. I think that's his name, Snacker. He looks like the shark from Donkey Kong Country, but, you know, in 3D. Wait, is that his name, Snacker? Oh, yeah, in Donkey Kong Country, the shark's name was Chomps. There was a big shark, Chomps, and that looked like that. Then there was Chomps Jr. that was like a little one. Whoa, you see that? It closed pretty quick. Okay, I think that's a safer way to get in. I probably should have done that first. Okay. There's a path over there. We're not going to go there yet. You do want to get an ability before going there because you need it to get a jiggy. There was a token down here. The only thing is, this is not a safe area. Here he comes. Yeah, Snacker, he just said his name. Yeah, every time you step in, he's gonna come out. I mean, I think the game glitches sometimes, and I've seen it to where... Oh, shoot. Wait, how do you... Oh, you know what? I don't think I need... I thought I had to shoot an egg in their mouths, but I think you just attack them regularly. Yep. Let me zoom out. The camera was so zoomed in. Okay, yeah, I should take this. But yeah, like I said earlier, there's so many different ways to, like, go about this world. Like I said, this is not the fastest way. This isn't a speed run, so I'm just kind of taking my time. Oh, that right there, what's that called? Shark Food Island. Right now, that's not important. That actually doesn't become anything really until after we beat the game. Sure, those of you that have beaten this game know what I'm talking about. Right now, it's just there, and there's a 1-up there too. I might try to go for that later. Oh wait, I shouldn't be grabbing these. What am I doing? Okay. So, this mine, we can actually get rid of him. I think one more should do it. There we go. Okay, I'm gonna grab these notes. You actually drain this little pond here. And we'll do that in a moment. You actually have to talk to that bucket that I pointed out earlier. It's actually easier if you drain the water to get these notes. But yeah, let me show what's in the sandcastle first. You can't do anything when it's flooded, though. Well, you can explore, but you can't do anything with the tiles here. And that's the main thing with this room here. Okay, let's get out of here. We'll drain the pond. Okay, so we just have to go around and talk to the bucket. Oh, oops. Oh, actually, we could learn a new move after this, too. Yeah, leaky. I was right. Okay, the pebbles are the eggs, so... Oops. Oh, you just need two. Okay, I thought you needed three. Actually, if you drain the water while that mine is still there, it blows up. Because it hits the sandcastle here. Okay, well... Let's head inside here. Okay, that crab is a little different than the ones that we've seen. I mean, besides his color, but he's actually a stronger version of them. You'll see in a moment. But the solution to this password is Banjo-Kazooie. See, it says it on the wall right there. This area is also important because you can put in cheat codes here. I'm not going to mess with those now. Maybe later. In like a bonus video or something. Oh wait, what was it? Banjo? Oh, I need the K. Oops. Wait, where's the K? Oh, here. They give you plenty of time, 100 seconds, so... Even though I messed up, I'm good. Okay, here's the O. Then... Okay, get ready when you hit the E. It's the attacks afterward. Oh, that missed. Oh, shoot. Oh. I was gonna say, it does take more hits to beat him, but I got him there anyway. And I think that's the only black crab that you see in this game. Everything else is like the green one. I think you do see the green ones in the next world? Might be wrong about that. I know there's crabs in the next world. I don't know if they're that exact one, though. Okay. We did the sandcastle part. Oh, let's learn the new move. Because that's very important to learn. Oh, there's a honeycomb piece over there. I'll get that once... I'm done with some of this other stuff here. It's actually easier to fly to that box. But yeah, let's talk to him. Okay, all of them are activated now. Okay, the shock jump disc. Alright, so yeah, only two new moves in this world. But yeah, you hold the jump button, and Kazooie will spring up in the air. Pretty high, actually. You can also do this. You don't have to be on the pad to do the second jump. But, actually, it's a little easier if you, like, don't do what I did there. I mean, if you mess up, you know, you can recover that way, but it's easier just to do this right here. I guess I'll go up here. Oh. Ooh, okay, I thought I was gonna roll off. Okay, let's get these notes. We're actually pretty close to getting all of them now. Yeah, you can see a crab on an island there. That island does have a purpose. But like some of the other stuff I pointed out, we'll get to it later. Okay, now I'm wondering what I should do next, because there's a thing right here. I'll do that. Then I might backtrack, because there was an area that I pointed out when you fly. Actually, when you first fly, on the right side. Oh, okay, I thought I wasn't going to make it. that I said that you needed the second move for. We'll get to that next. Okay, which Jiggy is this? Wait, is this number 5 in this world, or just over? Oh, okay, yeah. He's at 14 total. Okay, so yeah, let's go back up here. Then we're gonna take flight and go to the right side. There's one note to get here. Yeah, there's gonna be more in here. Okay, this actually takes you to the top of the mountain. Those guys look goofy. I think it's funny when you defeat one of them, they just explode in different pieces and their eyeballs get separated too. Okay, just be careful. I mean, you can fall off here. You end up in the bottom part of the world. But you'll definitely lose some health if you fall off in the wrong spot. Okay, there is a Jinjo here. Let's grab him. Okay, so we're only missing one, the orange one. And as you probably remember, once we get all of them, we'll get another Jiggy. Alright, I think that's all the stuff to collect here. I mean, there's some more eggs and stuff. Wait, what was that? Oh. I thought there was another object. It was just another tree. Okay, actually, let's just keep going this way. I think you could take that shortcut, but I think there's some eggs here. Some notes. Actually, you would skip these. Wait, right? Yeah, you would skip them. Never mind. Okay, here's the witch switch. I think that's what this is called. Okay, we'll get that after we're done here. And then, there's a door here that we can use to get inside the lighthouse. That'll take us to the top. Okay, and there's another Jiggy. Was this number 6? Yeah. Okay, so yeah, we are at the very top of this world. Actually, it's interesting playing this version after the 64 version. In the 64 version, this part is really foggy. In this version, you can pretty much see everything in the world here. That's pretty cool. Alright. I did notice that there's a lot of stuff that I still have to do. If you looked closely, there was a red X part. That's another path for a Jiggy. I could fall down, but let's take the safe way. Let's go down here. Okay, I didn't know where I was gonna land. Okay, I think you can defeat him by, pooping eggs on him, but it's just, temporary. He comes back anyway, so don't even bother with that. Oops. Okay, actually, there's some chests that I missed earlier, too. I can't remember if there's notes in them. But if I need to, I'll backtrack. Okay, there's definitely something over here. I don't remember what, though. Oh, shoot. At least he doesn't talk every single time that you fall in the water. I mean, most of the time he does, but it gets really annoying. It's like, yes, I know you're on your way. Jeez. You can tell by the music. Okay. So let's follow this egg path here and see what's over here. I think it's a Jiggy. Oh, yeah, it is. You know what? There's a... I think there's something around this corner. If not in this corner, then it's somewhere close to this part. I'm just gonna take the risk. I'm gonna jump in. He's probably gonna bite me. Yep. I think that... I know there's a honeycomb... Yep, there it is. Shoot, I'm probably gonna get bitten again. Let's get out here. Alright, got it. Okay, he does leave you alone after he bites you, but then he'll go after you again. Come on, hurry up, get out of here. Okay, actually, that's very convenient. I left myself this earlier, so thanks, past self. Okay. We still do have to deal with the water. Wait, do I want... Yeah, this is the part I was talking about. There's like some treasure chests here. Oh, shoot. It's weird, I got stuck on his teeth. Okay. Let's go up here. I know there's a mine. Yeah, there's one. Some notes here, too. That's pretty rude. Well, then again, I think he knows what's coming. But if you need some health, you can break one of those honeycomb boxes. And I think three come out? Let's see. Yeah, three. Okay, let's lure him over here. Wait, that missed. Oh, oops. Okay, you don't want those to blow up on you because it does hurt you a lot. You can blow them up if you want, or you can just ignore them. I think I'll just ignore him. Okay, let's go up here. This one I can blow up because he's in shallow water. There you go. Okay, I heard the Jinjo. Where is he? Is he down here? Oh, he might be up there. Let's keep going. But yeah, that is the last Jinjo. That should be... What was that? The orange one? Yeah. It's a good thing the game doesn't make you find them in order. That would be kind of annoying. Oh yeah, he's over here. Alright. Oh shoot! Ah, see, that's what I didn't want to happen. Okay, at least I didn't fall into the water, because that would have been even more annoying. There we go. Okay, that should be, what, number 7? Cool. Oh, 8. My bad, we had 7. There actually is another one right over here. So this will be number 9. I think it's down here. Yep. Let's go get that one. I'm gonna dive in. Okay, but yeah, if you get a Jiggy while you're underwater, there's no animation. Oh, shoot, he's right here. Okay. No, no! Okay, we're good, we're good. Let's get some of these. We're actually not missing very many now. Alright, well, what you got in here? Ooh, 2 tokens. Okay, yeah, there's no transformation in this world. Actually, I think the next world also lacks one. Jeez, when is the next one? Oh, okay, yeah, world 4, the swamp one. That one has a transformation. So we do have to wait a little bit for the next one, but the next one's actually pretty cool. I like it. Alright, so what do we have left? We have one Jiggy left, and I know it's the flying red X thing. We also have that honeycomb to get. I hope I don't forget that one. Oh, shoot. There we go. Wait, what's in here? Is it worth it? Okay, I'm not gonna mess with that anymore. I think this one just has eggs. I'll jump in just in case. Oh no! Okay, cool. Yeah, that one's important then. I did see a Mumbo token over here, so let's grab that and try not to get bitten here. Okay. Oh wait, there's the missing, wait. Oh, oops, I didn't mean to touch that. Also, I noticed the time on my Xbox 360 is totally wrong. It said, like, 7 a.m. Right now, it's like, I think 3 or 4 in the afternoon. Oh, that's all of them. Okay, cool. Oh, there's a 1-up. Yeah, that one's easy to get if you ground pound. Also, I'm going to point this out because I think the first couple videos were recorded in one session. But, your lives reset after you turn off the game. So, I think, yeah, I have 5 lives. I think when I ended the game last time, I had, like, almost 10. So, that's what that means. Okay. So, these red X's, what you want to do is do that on each one. Okay, so we have to find the next one, which I think is just around the corner. It's a little bit farther than... Yeah, there it is. So when you go to this plateau before, there's nothing there, but now the red X will show up after you hit the first one. Same with all the ones after this, too. Okay, that's number 2. Number 3 is actually a lot closer here. There's actually a move that makes you move forward faster, but we're not going to get that until a little bit later. The next one is right in front of our faces. The next one, actually, you could probably see it from here. Oh, I can't rotate the camera. But it's just over... Oh, oops. Just over here. We were actually on this island earlier. Or plateau, not island. But you can probably guess that island over here on the right side suddenly becomes useful. Okay, question mark. You'll never find me? Yes, we will, because this X is just right here. Alright, let's get rid of him first. Okay. It says, please open me gently. Unfortunately, there's only one way to open him up, and that's violently. So, yeah. And that's the last one. Kind of dark on this island. I guess like a shadow here. Anyway, the last thing that I'm going to do in this world is get that honeycomb. I could swim there, but what's his name? Snacker or whatever. He's probably going to bite me, so. Let's try to avoid that. Oh, there's no flight pad here. I think the next closest one is over here. But yeah, after that, that's pretty much it. I mean, there was an extra life that I pointed out earlier, but I don't really need it. Yeah, it's right over there. At least I don't think I need it. I hope not, because I'm not going to get it. Oh, there it is. See if I could land on the box. I had trouble doing that on the 64 version. But also on the 64 version, your visibility while you were flying around these parts, it was really bad. So, I do like flying more in this version. Yeah, take that. Okay, let's get out of here. We're done with this world. Damn right, yeah, 10... Jiggies, got all 5 Jinjos, all the notes, and then the 2 honeycombs in this world, so yeah, let's get out of here. I think you can just exit course, I'm just gonna walk out, I'm already here. Oop. That would've been bad. Okay, cool. So just like World 1, an enemy does escape the world. Oh, shoot. In this case, it's that crab. We did hit the witch switch. So let's grab... Oh, there's... Oh, wait, no. These things are always here. Like fake Donkey Kongs or whatever. Okay, but yeah, after hitting the witch switch, this is what we can get. This Jiggy in Gruntilda's lair. It's number 3. Is there anything? Yeah, there's nothing over there. Okay, well, that's pretty much it for this world. Before I end the video, we can actually open up the next world. And we can mess with some stuff here too, because I think there's a couple things you have to do before you actually go in that world. I think you have to open it here. We couldn't do this before because we didn't have this ability. Yeah, here we go. Clanker's Cavern. This is actually World 3. There we go. Okay, and that is World 3, Clanker's Cavern. Not my favorite world in the game. I mean, I don't mind it that much. I played it the other day. You know, my non-recording file, and it wasn't as bad as I remember it. Maybe it's because, you know, there's some slight changes to the, oh, that was weird, to the, Xbox version. Nothing, like, major, but there's some things I definitely noticed that are different, but, you know, for the better. But, I guess I didn't hate it as much as I did when I was a kid. Okay, actually, I think we can go up here, too. I don't remember if you can get the, I think there's a Jiggy here, but I think you have to hit the switch in the, Oh, here's Gruntilda. The only thing is, I will not remember all this stuff. I might have to, like, write all this stuff down, because, like I said, I do have a non-recording file. And the answers are different in that one, so I'm gonna be confused when it comes time to using those answers. Actually, can we do that now? Let's check this out. I actually don't remember where this goes. Oh, we can actually unlock World 4 now. We'll come back to that. We'll do that in the next video. But yeah, Bubble Gloop Swamp is World 4. There's actually a part in there I wasn't sure, but I thought it was one of those worlds where you have to get an ability that's in a different world, but this one it's optional. I mean, I'm not sure, because... The ability that you get, like I said, you can totally get a Jiggy without the ability. That's in, I think, I can't remember what world you get it in. Is it 6? Anyway, it's just harder without it, but it makes, when you get the ability, getting that Jiggy is super easy. But I've always done, when I was a kid, I always did it with the ability. I, like, always came back. So, we'll see when it comes time to recording that. Alrighty, that is it for this video. In the next video, we're going to head to the next world. Clanker's Cavern is the entrance to it right here. Oh, wait, I didn't hit this yet. Or maybe I did. Okay. Anyway, thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.